自从我尝试用这个做雕塑以后，我觉得哎，这个做出来的感觉还是蛮有意思的，然后就一直去用这个去做尝试各种造型的。我每做一个东西，我都会去想象出它做出来那种感觉。
One person's trash is another's treasure. All these majestic sculptures you see, they have one thing in common. They're all built from trash. This unseemly ground littered with used tires is actually Cao Shengge's art studio in China's Hebei province near Beijing. Here, Cao creates sculptures using worn out tires.
其实刚开始吧，我觉得本来是做文员嘛，然后我觉得做那个其实是蛮没有挑战性的，其实是挺枯燥的。我觉得我本身学的是美术嘛，然后我又喜欢动手做一些东西，所以说，哎，就接触到这个行业里面来。
Making tire sculptures is painstaking work. Cao Shengge says it requires deep research and a good understanding of different materials.You have to conceive of the image in your mind and then design the drawings. The internal frame of the artwork is built with steel bars. Once the frame is done, Cao begins carving out the tires. He first removes the rubber belt from the tire and cuts it into small squares. He then puts the pieces on the bars with steam nails, little by little, to shape the texture of the outer layer of the model.
肯定得去看一些动漫，还有去体验一些游戏，因为它里面很多好的设计都在里面。
To make a typical tire sculpture, Cao would cut tens of thousands of tires into small pieces. One artwork could take 10 days to even months from start to finish.
肌肉的一个走向，包括动物啊，包括人物这个骨骼这些东西是最难的。解决的方法其实也就是做多了也就会了，多看多学，多去网上去找一些动物的解剖之类的，就是这样一个学习的过程吧。有这么一个，就是中国文化里面的蚩尤，这个是我做的最难受的一个，因为当时它是三头六臂嘛，我没做过类似这种结构的，我不知道它去怎么去长出三个头，还有它这个在哪里长着这六个胳膊，其实这个时候是最难的。
In 2019, Cao Shengge started to film his production process and put it out on social platforms. He's a social media star now, with followers on Bilibili and TikTok, among others. One of his most popular videos garnered nearly 12 million views.
我也没想到会有这么多粉丝，但是我觉得，既然大家这么支持我的话，我觉得我还会去做。更做下去吧，然后做更多他们感兴趣的一些东西。如果一个人经常无人问津的话，我觉得是挺没意思的。不过这多朋友一直是关注着这个事儿，我觉得，哎，我就挺满足的，挺幸福的。
Among Cao's regular customers are game and toy manufacturers who commission work for product promotion. His sculptures sell for an average of about $15,700.Or 122,000 Hong Kong dollars. Cao's work has gradually become a family business. These days, his father helps him buy used tires from a local tire factory, and his sisters assist him with errands.
也没想过去通过这个去挣钱之类的。刚开始也就是一个兴趣，只是一个兴趣。然后我全家刚开始他们还是挺支持，我觉得是挺支持的，至少没反对。我觉得一家人在一块儿，哎，为了一件事儿而挺高兴、挺愉快的去做一件事，而且还能解决一个温饱问题，其实这样的话，我就觉得挺满足的。